Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshad Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be discussing with you regarding Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, his biography, his achievements and his role in the Indian freedom struggle. All of these things I will be discussing with you in very much detail, friends. So this is presented by me. If you want to follow me, friends, the link of my Instagram profile is given in the description box below, friends. Also, if you want to watch the same video in the Hindi language, the Hindi version of the video is also uploaded on my channel, friends, and its link is also given in the description box below. So Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, who is also known as the Iron Man of India, friends, we'll be discussing everything about him. He was born on 31st of October 1875 at a place named Nadiad, which was present in Bombay Presidency at that time and which is the present day Gujarat state of India. The name of his father was Zaver Bhai, Z-A-V-E-R, okay, friends, and also the name of his wife was Zaver Bhai, okay, so this Z becomes J-H-A in the name of his wife, so the names are quite similar to each other, but that is not important. The name of his mother was Lad Bhai, and the name of his children were Mani Ben Patel and Dahaya Bhai Patel. Okay, friends, so he was associated with Indian National Congress. We very well know that Indian freedom struggle, he has a huge role in it. And he finally passed away on 15th of December 1950. So we'll discuss everything about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel ji, friends, everything. Actually, he is a very important name in Indian politics. And the biggest thing which he is known for is that after India became independent, he is credited to have associated more than 500 princely states, the Raja Rajwades of that time, into the Union of India, friends. One important fact about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel is that he was a staunch follower of the policies and methodologies of Mahatma Gandhi, friends. And the biggest thing about him is that he was a staunch nationalist. Reason that he was a very potential candidate for becoming the Prime Minister, that is the first Prime Minister of independent India. But despite being the most, known candidate, the most important candidate for becoming the Prime Minister of India, he was not appointed the Prime Minister. Jawaharlal Nehru became the Prime Minister. Reason being that Mahatma Gandhi said that the post of the Congress President was given to Jawaharlal Nehru and not Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Now, that person who was the Congress president would become the Prime Minister of India. That was known at that point of time. So Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was being asked by Mahatma Gandhi to step down, okay, from the post of Congress president and let Jawaharlal Nehru become the Congress president, which would be the future Prime Minister of independent India. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel agreed to this fact. At this point of time, if Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel would have wanted, he wouldn't have chosen the post of Congress president, but he stepped down willingly because he was very much in favor for the progress and, you know, prosperity of the nation. He was not for his personal benefit. And there is one more question on which many historians have talked a lot, is that why Gandhiji nominated Jawaharlal Nehru to be the president of Congress and to become the future Prime Minister of independent India, the first future Prime Minister of independent India, not Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. The reason for this, which is being told by many different historians, is that, friends, see, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was born in 1875, friends. So in 1947, the age of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was 25 plus 47, which is around 72 years. Whereas Jawaharlal Nehru was born in 1889, friends. So his age at the time of independence, that is 1947, was around 58 years. So Jawaharlal Nehru was, comparatively quite young from Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. And this was the reason that Jawaharlal Nehru was appointed by Gandhiji to be the Congress President and the future Prime Minister of independent India, because Gandhiji thought that Jawaharlal Nehru can take India to quite a big, far stage. And at that point of time, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel used to be sick. He was very old. So it was said that it is better that if Jawaharlal Nehru lead the country and not Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. And to this, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel agreed willingly. He didn't show any hesitation in doing this, friends. Okay. He has earned the title of Iron Man of India because he is credited with being associating more than 500 principalities and provinces into the Union of India. Now, as I've already told you, he was born on 31st of October 1875 in modern-day Gujarat in the Nadiad village. His father used to work in the army of Queen of Jhansi. His mother was a very, you know, he was a very spiritual and believing in God type of woman. Okay, friends. The education of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, it started in a Gujarati medium school. Later on, he transferred himself to an English medium school. See, friends, whatever I'm telling you, about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, kindly listen it in a story form. Don't refer to the text that I have written here. This text is not of much use. Whatever I'm telling you, it is in a story form. I will try to make it as interesting as possible for you. Okay, so that this thing becomes a proper, you can say, a sort of storytelling for you, so that some interest comes in. Okay, friends. Now, what happened that in 1897, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel ji completed his high school and he wanted to pursue and study law. So, for studying law, he went to England in 1910. He started studying law in England, and by 1913, he acquired his law degree from Inns of Court College in England. After that, he came back to India and started practicing his law at a place named Godhra in Gujarat. Now, this Godhra is the same place where the Godhra riots, the Godhra train scandal took place, friends. But right, this was actually after a lot of time of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. So, for some time in Godhra, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was working. And after that, Patel started working in the city of Ahmedabad. Now, when he was working as a lawyer, when he was involved in his law profession, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was known for his efficiency and proficiency in this subject of law. So, many lucrative posts and offers were given to him by the British government and other private people. But Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was a very staunch nationalist and he was very much anti-Britisher in character. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel said that I will never prefer working for this British government because my country is a servant of this British government. So I will never work for this British government. So he left many, you know, lucrative opportunities that were thrown to him. Then when he moved to Ahmedabad, before this one more fact, friends, he was married in 1891 and he had two children. The name of his children were, in the first, the children was Manibhen Patel and second was Dahiya Bhai Patel. Okay, these information is not mandatory, friends. So when he moved to Ahmedabad, he became a member of the Gujarat Club. He started attending a lecture of Mahatma Gandhi. One lecture he attended of Mahatma Gandhi at that point of time. He became a staunch follower of Mahatma Gandhi. He considered Mahatma Gandhi as his political guru because Gandhian principle became a big, you know, had a big effect on Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Now, what happened, friends, that in 1917, and mind it, 1917, this time is very much close to the time when Gandhiji came to India. Gandhiji came to India in January of 1916. In 1917, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was elected as the secretary of the Gujarat Sabha. Now, this Gujarat Sabha was the Gujarat wing of the Indian National Congress. After that, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel associated himself with many nationalistic movements. The very first movement I will talk about is 1918. He associated himself with the Kheda Satyagraha. This was the no tax campaign, friends. Okay, now this Kheda Satyagraha video I have already made in detail. I have explained it. I have explained the role of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, how it proceeded, how it ended. Everything I have explained, friend. So I will give the link of Kheda Satyagraha in the description box below. You please go and watch that video. Okay, friends. Now, during his role, during these satyagrahas, he was given the title of Sardar by the women who were associated with him in this satyagraha, friends. Also, in 1920, when non-cooperation movement was launched by Gandhiji, he supported Gandhiji with his full support. He used to tour the nation with Gandhiji, go from place to place. He recruited 3 lakh members and collected around 15 lakh rupees for this cause, friends. Then came, after some time, you can say, the role in Bardoli Satyagraha, friends. Bardoli Satyagraha happened in 1928 and it was against the problem of tax hike I have also made a video on Bardoli Satyagraha. Friendly, go and watch that video on Bardoli Satyagraha. I will give the link in the description box below. So in this Bardoli Satyagraha, friends, Sardar ji, also this Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, also revolted against this tax hikes. He urged the peasants and farmers to remain loyal and violent in their approach. He said that you don't need to pay taxes to the government. The government should know that due to this famine, due to this bad monsoon, crops are not there, so we will not be able to pay the taxes. So in that case, what happened, that government used to take away the lands of those farmers. But when this Bardoli Satyagraha ended, friends, it was in the favor of the farmers. And even when it ended, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel worked tooth and nail, fought tooth and nail to get those land returns to the original owner. Such was his deal of devotion to the cause of the people, the farmers, friends. Okay, so this was the role of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Also, friends, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel also associated himself with Gandhi ji during the Salt Satyagraha movement. You know that Salt Satyagraha movement was launched in 1930 by Mahatma Gandhi, and this was chosen as the formal start of the civil disobedience movement by Mahatma Gandhi. Now, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was associated with Mahatma Gandhi in the Salt Satyagraha. He was arrested in 1930. Then, in 1913, there was a pact between Lord Irwin and Gandhiji, which was known as the Gandhi-Irwin Pact of 1931. So, when this Gandhi-Irwin Pact of 1931 took place, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel ji was released from the jail, and the videos relating to Salt Satyagraha, the civil disobedience movement, and the Gandhi-Irwin Pact have already been uploaded by me on my channel, friends. I will give those links in the description box below, friends. Also, after this Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed, this Gandhi-Irwin Pact was being ratified by the Indian National Congress at its Karachi session. And one important fact to remember is that when this Karachi session took place in 1931, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was elected as the president of this session. And this session was very important because in this session, the fundamental working way of Indian National Congress, the National Economic Program of the Indian National Congress, was decided. Also, this was the same session which, when the Indian National Congress leaders came to attempt, they were shown black flags all along their path because they believed that Gandhi ji didn't try lot to save Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev and Rajguru from being hanged. Okay, friends. Now, after that, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was associated in a lot of activities, friends. In 1942, when Quit India movement was launched by Gandhiji, then also Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel used to give inspiring speeches, heartfelt speeches. He was, imprisoned. He remained in jail for a whole lot of time, friends. And also during when these things were happening, friends, on the ideological point also, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel came into confrontation with a lot of other leaders of Indian National Congress. The very first name that comes to our mind is the name of Subhash Chandra Bose. I have already made a video on Haripura session and Tripuri session, the rift between Subhash Chandra Bose and Indian National Congress. Now, in that I have told you, that link I will also give in the description box below. So, in that I told you that Subhash Chandra Bose once said that the followers of Gandhi ji are of low intellectual level. Now, in those followers of Gandhi ji, one was Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel also. So, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel and other followers of Gandhi ji were in open rift with Subhash Chandra Bose on his ideology. And then came the Panth resolution and all of those things I have already covered. Friends, kindly go there. He even resigned from the Congress Working Committee when Subhash Chandra Bose tried to extend the meeting from February to March. Every of these things in detail I have covered there, friends. Okay. Once upon a time, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel also came in conflict with Jawaharlal Nehru ji on his ideology to adopt socialism. In 1936, Jawaharlal Nehru was very much vocal about his support towards socialism. So this was refuted too by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Okay, friends. Now, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was also involved in a lot of activities, friends. When India became free, he was the first Home Minister of Independent India, and he was also the first Deputy Prime Minister of India. And as I have already told you, that after India became independent, it was free from the British clutches. There was a huge task of integrating the newly formed 562 princely states into India, because the Indian Independence Act, which is also famously known as Mountbatten Act, it said that all the provinces have the choice to join either the Dominion of India or the Dominion of Pakistan or become independent. So this act, in the Indian Independence Act, gave the power to the provinces to become independent. Now it became very difficult to integrate those with the Indian Union, because if a province is being given a power to become independent, why will it surrender its sovereignty to someone else? But despite that fact, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel integrated all those 562 principalities in the Indian Dominion. Friends, only three principalities were there in which Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel got problem. They were Jammu and Kashmir, Junagadh and Hyderabad. Now in Jammu and Kashmir, we all know what happened, friends. Jammu and Kashmir was declared as independent by Raja Hari Singh. They said that they didn't want to join Pakistan or India, but Pakistan forces along with Azad Kashmir forces attacked Jammu and Kashmir. So Raja Hari Singh came to Jawaharlal Nehru and acceded to India. So where the army stopped, that became the international boundary, and today that is the status quo. Also, in case of Hyderabad, friends, Hyderabad was not ready to join into India. So Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, you know, executed the police action in order to accede Hyderabad to India, friends. So what India we are seeing today is a big effort is of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Also, friends, when the Constituent Assembly was formed, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel had a very important role in the forming of that Constituent Assembly. And as we know that the father of our Constituent Assembly, the father of our constitution is B.R. Ambedkar. So B.R. Ambedkar was assigned the task of drafting the Constitution of India on the recommendations of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel ji. Also, the two biggest services of India for which almost all of the Indian youths are crazy, that is the Indian Administrative Services and in the Indian Police Services, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was very much instrumental in establishing the Indian Administrative Services and in the Indian Police Services. He was very much instrumental in, establishing these services and giving them the powers. Even the Police Academy in Hyderabad is named after him. Okay, friends. Also, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel acted and helped Nehru ji in his full capacity. It was not like that he is not become the Prime Minister, so he was trying to stop or restrict Nehru ji or not helping him. He was hell-bent. He was a very nationalist person. He was behind Nehru ji and helped him all through. And he even pointed out the mistakes of Nehru ji which he took during his role as the Indian Prime Minister. For example, the role of or the stance of Nehru ji on refugees from Pakistan was being refuted by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Once Nehruji said in the United Nations that he will conduct referendum in Kashmir. So this was also refuted by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. So all these important things, it was being told. And many a times, friends, Gandhiji was criticized for his actions from leaders like C. Rajagopalachari, Maulana Azad, Jawaharlal Nehru, for withdrawing the non-cooperation movement, the civil disobedience movement. But Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was one such person who was hell-bent in support of Gandhiji. He was a staunch follower and disciple of Gandhiji. Now, when Gandhiji was associated by Nathuram Godse, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was very much affected by him. He got a major heart attack when he heard the news that Gandhiji is dead now. He survived that attack, but still, that thing remained in his mind, friends. Okay, and also you can see, friends, that his health also started deteriorating in 1950, friends. And finally, he breathed his last on 15th of December 1950 due to a massive heart attack, friends. After his death in 1991, he has been awarded the highest civilian honor of India, named as Bharat Ratna. And his birthday, that is 31st of October, is celebrated across India from 2014 as the Rashtriya Ekta Divas. So if someone asks you when is the Rashtriya Ekta Divas, it is on 31st of October. So this was the complete biography of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. I have told you in the form of a story. I hope this thing was helpful for you, friends. So if this thing was helpful for you, friends, kindly tell me through your comments. You can subscribe to my channel, like my video. And friends, if you are not liking it, you can also dislike it, but kindly please tell me why you're disliking it, friends, and as far as possible, please share this video with more and more of your friends. So thank you, friends. Have a great day. Goodbye.